The number one question I get, and it's been the number one question or inquiry that I have gotten for years, is, Jimmy, how do I grow on YouTube? Jimmy, how do I launch a channel? How do I get to 100 subs? How do I get to 1,000 subs? What am I doing wrong? Why can't I grow? Is YouTube against me? Is it pure luck to blow up on YouTube? These are the type of questions that I get tweeted at and in the comment section and in my email all of the time. So I thought I would put together a video to help you guys get started on your YouTube path if this is something that you have decided to do. And no, there is no special formula in here that you're going to shoot up and have PewDiePie numbers, but I am going to give you some insight, some steps, and some thoughts that maybe some of these other videos that have done this didn't quite touch on. And as we get started, in the comment section, let me know what your channel is all about. As this video goes out, I will be spending some time checking the channels that people put in the comment sections as well. I'm always looking for a cool new channel to watch. And so I present to you 10 steps on how to get to 1,000 subscribers on YouTube. Step number one, upload consistently. And you're probably saying, come on, Jimmy, we've all heard this one. This isn't anything special. No, it's not, but it is a foundation of how you can grow a channel. If you look at the successful channels out there, most of them rely on consistent uploads, whether that be daily uploads, 2 daily uploads. I see some bigger channels that do 5 daily uploads or even bi-daily uploads. So they upload every other day. But whatever they do, their schedule is consistent. I have seen so many channels die over the years. I'm going to take a week off. I'm not feeling it. I'm going to take a month off. I'll come back and I'll hit it super hard when I'm ready. And the second they do that, their channel suffers. There used to be a time on YouTube where you could upload 1 to 2 videos a week if you were a big channel and you could sustain, but it's not that way anymore. There may be a very, very special small group that can do it, but for the most part, it's consistency and repetition because people want to see what they want to see. And if they don't see what they want to see from you, they will go find it somewhere else because there are a million other channels in line ready to hand them content if you aren't. Step number two, and this is going to sound kind of off for a second, but hear me out on this. Trending topics and clickbait. Now, what do I mean by that? Now, if you want to do your channel and you are a fan of growing roses in a garden, then by all means, go grow roses in a garden. But that doesn't seem to be a very popular topic right now on YouTube. So what do I mean by trending and clickbait? You need to focus on trending topics and clickbait. Now, hold on, Jimmy. What do you mean clickbait? How dare you tell people that the way to grow their channel is clickbait? Let's get in reality, people, okay? I want you to come with me for just a second, and I want you to look. All of the big channels have figured out ways to incentivize people to click on their videos. Now, I am not saying clickbait in the terms of lying about your content, but it is a special art when you can make your thumbnail and your title coexist with the content in the video and make people want to click on it. You want them to click on it. It's no different than when somebody goes to Walmart and they go to the checkout and all of those candy bars and packs of gum are lined there at a certain level. They paid somebody to study on what certain height level and where to put those within hand's reach because people are impulsive and they will buy it. It is no different than the YouTube sub box. People are impulsive. They will click on something that they feel they want to know what's actually going on with that story behind the thumbnail. So figure out how to involve your content with trending topics that people want to watch. Remember, you want to get to 1,000 subs. You need to be putting out content that is interesting to people, and you may have your special genre that you want to do, but you got to figure out a way to mix the trending topics with your content. And with that, you need to know how to title and how to actually clickbait. I hate the word clickbait because it's more about creativity. The ones that are clickbait that are bad are the ones that just they give you false information. There's nothing in context with their content relevant with their thumbnail and title. Those are bad, but somebody that's creative to get you to click on a video with a cool thumbnail and a title that is relevant, to me, that is perfect. If you guys would like a focused video on exactly that, how to title, tag and thumbnail your videos and focus on trending topics, let me know in the comment section and we could do that as a follow-up video to this one. Step number three on your road to 1,000 subscribers. People like to judge on the end result of where a YouTuber is, but people rarely see the grind that went into where that YouTuber got where they're going. What I mean by that is everybody sees PewDiePie, or everybody sees KSI, or your favorite vlog channel, or Rooster Teeth, and people don't put that with all the hard work and the grinding that these channels did for years. Most of these big channels have been YouTubing for multiple years. We're talking over 5 years. Yes, there are some that hit lightning in a bottle and they go viral, but for the most part, your dedicated channels that are out there have been grinding for years, and people tend to forget that. So when you're looking and you're looking up at all these massive channels, don't let it deter you. Don't let it bring you down. Remember, they were where you are at one point in their career. That is big. It's mental focus is a huge part of this. You have to have clarity and you have to have consistency and not let anything affect you or bother you. All you can focus on is your reality, your little bubble of what you're doing with your YouTube. You can't judge you versus somebody else. Step number four, and this goes without saying, everybody knows this, but I have to put it in there just in case there is somebody that isn't aware of it. Equipment. You have to have decent quality for your videos. We are past the stage of 480p, people, and I know most everybody knows that, but I still go on YouTube, I still browse, and I still see people uploading content like that, and you can get decent quality even with a cell phone camera now. So equipment, and I understand equipment is expensive, so do it in baby steps with what you need, but get the base equipment, research, and once again, I could do another video and help you guys out with that if you wanted to as well. But there is equipment out there that is affordable. You don't have to go out and get the $1,000 mic that your favorite YouTuber has, or this amazing camera that this guy has. There is equipment out there that you can use that is affordable. So budget shop. There is nothing wrong with budget shopping. I know you want to have that gaming setup or that YouTube setup and let everybody see it, but that's for a different time. That's for down the road. Don't focus on that right now. Step number five. There are no original ideas. Well, there may be occasionally, but they're very, very rare. Most ideas have been used and rehashed and turned around and manipulated into something else. And that's okay. They aren't really around anymore because we're on the internet. We have access to everything, but it is okay for you to put your spin on a popular idea. There is nothing wrong with that. Forget all the people that say, oh, don't copy his content, or you're just doing what he did. If you see something fun like a top 10 or a series or a vlogging channel, or hell, the trend right now is mailing yourself in a box. If you want to give it a try in your own spin, go for it. Don't listen to people. You can do what you want. Just put your spin on it. A perfect example is my top 10 series. I in no way created top 10s at all. Wasn't even close to the first person, but what I did was put my spin on it and made it a community feel with Twitter. So that's how I've done my top 10s on Sundays. I involve Twitter, they get to be showcased in the top 10s, and that is my little spin on top 10s. You guys can do the same thing. There is nothing wrong with taking an idea and putting your spin on it. Step number six, don't battle sub boxes during prime time. What I mean by that is there is a prime time for YouTube for most people. It's usually between 1 p.m. to about 4 to 5 p.m. depending on your time zone. That is when the bulk of the videos go up. As a small channel, don't battle that primetime sub box placement. You're not going to win. You're just going to get swallowed up. So check your analytics, dive into your analytics, see who's watching, see when they're watching, and then upload off a time that you can get away with that's not during prime time. Go during an off-peak time. Now, you may not get as many views, okay? But you will be able to get out there a little more because you aren't saturated during the prime time that most of your bigger YouTubers are uploading. So I would suggest in the evening, or depending on your time zone, in the morning, just try to work your way around the prime time of sub boxes, because you will. You will get swallowed up, you'll get frustrated, and nobody will see your content. Step number seven, interact. And this goes without saying, but I'm gonna say it anyway. Reply to comments, tweets, anything that you can do to show these people that are taking 5 minutes out of their day to engage with you in a busy, busy world where things are going fast, Show them that you actually care. Engage with them. That is one thing I have always done and I will continue to do, is engage with my viewer base. It is the most important thing because they're there for you. You need to be there for them as well. Step number 8, I want to post what I want to post. I've heard this numerous times. Well, I want to post what I want to post. I don't care what goes on. Well, there's two choices here. There's a fork in the road for you. If you want to go down the left path and post whatever you want to post, then by all means do it. You have free will choice and it's a free world and you can do that. But if you want to go down the path of growing your channel, you have to put that to the side. It can't be a I want to post what I want to post mentality. Yes, you can post what you're passionate about, but like I said earlier, it needs to be able to connect to trending topics that people are looking for and they have to want to click on it. So yes, post. If you like video games, post video games. If you like vlogs, post vlogs, but you need to make sure that those are intertwined with what people are actually searching on YouTube. Step number 9, thumbnails. Now we talked a little bit about it in step number 2 with trending topics, clickbaits, and titles, but thumbnails is by far the most important thing. You need to learn Photoshop, get somebody that can help you. You want to have eye-popping thumbnails because they are the first line of defense in getting somebody incentivized to click on your content. A lot of people don't even read titles anymore. They simply judge by the thumbnail. And it is, to me, the most important piece of getting somebody to go watch your videos. And once again, there's a fine line and an art to making a clickbait thumbnail that is also contextual to the content that you have in the video. So thumbnails, thumbnails, thumbnails. Focus on your thumbnails. Step number 10, the final step of this video, have realistic expectations on your growth. Do not start your channel and look at all the big channels and say, I want to be growing 5,000 subs a day and 500,000 views a day. I want to be there. If you focus on that, you'll never get there because you're focused on what they're doing instead of your little bubble and your reality. Focus on yourself. Focus on your expectations. If you start out and you get 10 subscribers the first week, try to get 20 subscribers the next week. If you get 50 views on a video for the first time, try to get 100 views on the next one. Baby steps your way up. And you'll find as you go, it'll start to snowball on its own, and it has nothing to do with you. It has to do with your body of work. Now, I'm going to give you guys two thoughts really quick. This is a long video, but think about this. One, you have an advantage being small. I know that sounds crazy, and YouTube is just a whirlwind of crap right now, and nobody knows how to figure out the algorithm, so on and so forth. But if the algorithm is what people are saying it is, and it's got to do something with click-through rate of your subs, it is advantageous for smaller channels because they don't have all of those dead subscribers. So you may be an advantage by being small. If you build that core base and they come back every video and watch, you are going to see some growth. You're going to see some snowball effect as you go if you stay consistent. And the other little piece of advice from me to you is group up. Find people that have the same focus and drive as you that are around your size. There's a reason that the Sidemen do so well, or the FaZe Clan does so well, or the TK House, or all these little groups. They're not little anymore, but these groups of people that work together with their content and they help each other grow. So if you can, find people around your size that want to collab and intertwine. One shout out doesn't do it anymore, people. Not in 2017, but if you find some people that consistently want to produce content with you, you're at an advantage. And that is it, guys. 10 steps to help you get your first 1,000 subscribers in a week in 2017 on YouTube. I hope this was helpful. If it was, drop a like on the video. Tell me about your channel in the comment sections, and I will be checking them out as this video goes out. Hope you have a fantastic day, and I'll see you later.